There is one typical conversation, discussion that I have with other professing Christians, and this is a division between two camps. The first camp says that we need to not only believe, but we need to repent and obey the words of Jesus. We need to turn away from sin. True repentance means to stop sinning. This is what the first camp says. Then you have the other camp, which says that we don't need to obey, we only need to believe. We are saved by grace through faith alone, and that means that anything that we try to do, whether stop sinning, obeying, that is works, and we are trying to gain salvation by our works. Now, all through these heated discussions, these two camps accuse each other of being deceived, that is to say the least. Without talking about how we sometimes even accuse each other of having demons, of being wicked, and all through these personal attacks, we are lost and confused, and sometimes we even wonder. I used to wonder whether I was deceived because I wasn't sure. But since I grew up in my relationship with Christ, I realized which of these two is right and which is being deceived. I'm not gonna speak about my experiences, how Jesus Christ led me to the truth when it comes to these discussions. Who is right and who is being deceived? I'm just gonna go to the Holy Scriptures, and the Holy Scriptures are there for us to instruct us. Like Paul, the Apostle Paul says that the Holy Scriptures serve as instruction for us so that we are guided into the truth, so that we are corrected. So how do we know which camp is being deceived? Which camp is right and which is being deceived? Is it the first camp who says that we not only need to believe, we also need to repent, we also need to be baptized in water, and we need to turn away from sin, walk in holiness, following Jesus Christ until the end to be saved? Or is it the second camp who says that the only thing we need to do is believe? We don't need to obey because that would mean that we are saved by our own works. A good way to know who is being deceived is to go to the scriptures and to search in the New Testament for these words: be not deceived. If you go into the translation KJV and search for this expression, be not deceived, you will realize that you will have three passages, and I want to read to you these passages today. The first one is in 1 Corinthians 6, verse 9 to 11. Paul says, "Know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Be not deceived, neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor effeminate, nor abusers of themselves with mankind, nor thieves, nor covetous, nor drunkards, nor revilers, nor extortioners shall inherit the kingdom of God. And such were some of you, but ye are washed, but ye are sanctified, but ye are justified in the name of the Lord Jesus and by the Spirit of God." Is this passage talking about sin? You decide, dear friends. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 33-34. "Be not deceived. Evil communications corrupt good manners. Awake to righteousness and sin not, for some have not the knowledge of God. I speak this to your shame." And finally, this is the book of Galatians, chapter 6, verse 7. "Be not deceived. God is not mocked, for whatever a man sows, that shall he also reap. For he that sows to his flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption, but he that sows to the Spirit shall of the Spirit reap life everlasting." So who is being deceived, dear friends? Do you realize that when we see this expression, the passages are only talking about people who are living in deliberate sin? We never see a passage saying, "Be not be deceived. You can keep on sinning because if you think you can keep your salvation by stopping sin, by obeying, then you think you can save yourself by your own works." We don't have these kinds of passages. What we have is passages telling Christians, people who profess to be Christians, not to be deceived because of them walking in sin, because some think that they can keep living in sin and be saved. So Paul says to them, don't be deceived by thinking that you can walk in sin and still be saved. These are very clear passages for the ones who want to be honest with the Holy Scriptures and with God. Deep down, we know, dear friends, who is the one being deceived. Now, one final thing I want to say. This is a good indication, brothers and sisters, that we are deceived. If we are walking in deliberate sin and we think that we will not have any consequences, that we will still be saved, then this is a good indication that we are being deceived. It doesn't matter which excuse we will use in order to keep living in deliberate sin. There are many ways the devil can deceive. The false ideologies and the doctrines are many. But one common objective of all these ideologies, of all these doctrines, is to bring people to believe that they can still be saved while continuing to live in willful sin. So the excuse doesn't matter. You can think maybe that we can repent at the last second and therefore continue living in willful sin. You can think maybe that you are once saved, always saved, that even if you do sin, you will never lose it. So the objective is still the same, to keep living in sin. You can think maybe that according to Calvinism, God will do his best to force you to be saved, to correct you and rebuke you later, so that you pay a bit more or you suffer a bit more before you are saved, with the objective being the same, that you can keep on willfully sinning. So what will you decide, dear friend? Will you look to these passages and examine yourself to see whether you are deceived or not? Are you deceived? Are you walking in willful sin? Are you using doctrine as an excuse to keep living in willful sin? Are you using different ideologies? Are you using the thief on the cross to say to yourself that you can keep willfully sinning? If you are still living in sin, you have never been delivered, dear friend. You have never met the Lord Jesus. You need to go to Jesus to deliver you from sin. Jesus Christ can erase your past sins. He can give you a new beginning. He makes us new inside. He changes us. He cleans us up. He washes us with his blood. After we are born again, we have the Holy Spirit of God living inside of us. And if we yield to him, if we let ourselves be guided by the Holy Spirit, then we will overcome sin. We will not be dominated by the powers of sin anymore, because the Holy Spirit will live inside of us and help us overcome. Do you have the Holy Spirit, dear friend? Do you have Jesus Christ as your Lord and Master? Are you following our King? Or are you just living willfully under the dominion of sin? Are you being deceived? And may God bless you.